focus on what I see makes this school different. At Princeton, I'm up against kids from the most elite high schools in the world. I mean, these are schools with study abroad programs, with members of royal families, with Juilliard preparatory courses. I have a friend who had a tank driving class at his high school. I have friends with fives on 17 AP tests. I took eight, one of them we didn't even offer a class for. I know some of you guys are probably thinking, wow, how could my kid ever compete? How could Justin-Siena ever compete? And Mr. Jordan's probably thinking, wow, why is Christian so speaking? But these are all legitimate questions, and here's the thing. As a graduate of Justin-Siena, I am competing and I am succeeding. Why? Well, frankly, it's because of this school. I'm not gonna lie and say that Justin's gonna turn your kid into a Broadway performer, a track superstar at Stanford, or a writer at Harvard, even though we do have graduates doing all of those things. But I will say that Justin is a place where your child will be thought of and cared for as a human being and as a child of God. Notice I say, as a human being, not as a student or as an athlete or even as a leader. I say this because the focus here, from my experience, was always on the person as a whole. Here I learned about service, not from textbooks, but from experience. My sophomore year, I spent a week on the Blackfoot Reservation in Montana, working at the science school there. That same year, I also participated in a civil rights protest in Georgia, and I worked at a soup kitchen in San Francisco and Los Angeles. My senior year, I spent a semester working at Meadows in Napa Valley, the retirement community there. And we actually still keep in touch with them, me and my friend who volunteered there. And just this winter, we attended their Christmas party. There was a United Nations trip that my friend Meg went on. From there, she worked with the support of this school to start a nationwide campaign and raised over $20,000 in the course of 4 months. But it's not just these extraordinary opportunities that taught me the value of service here. It was also the example that I saw every day from a faculty and staff at Children's Care. I mentioned that an AP test that I took out of class. That was only because Mr. Yen volunteered to lead independent AP physics study sessions during flex times. I know Mr. Swain and Ms. Lopez, if they're here, last summer they decided to practice what they preached by volunteering at an orphanage in India. Coach Petrugo, after a football game, my junior year, sat in his office listening to me cry and vent for an hour and a half. And Mr. Hester was our principal, but also my small group leader on a four-day retreat. And I would challenge any of you to find that at one of the high schools of my Princeton friends. And this is where I think Justin-Siena stands out. During my time here, I learned also about leadership. Here I went from the kid who climbed through a window and got locked in the boys' bathroom, the kid who Mrs. Bigley yelled at during football games, and whose senior G repeatedly threatened to call my parents after Spanish class, to the kid in charge of putting together a code of conduct for our student leaders. Now, a lot of the teachers don't know this, but I actually punched a kid in my freshman year, and I kicked a hole in a wall my sophomore year. And here I am speaking to the parents of incoming freshmen as I'm assuming a model of alumnus, so my point is this. At any other school, I could have easily entered a selfish troublemaker and left still a selfish troublemaker. Instead, the school pushed me constantly to recognize there's a tremendous responsibility that comes with leadership. I was pushed by Mr. Bailey during our numerous encounters freshman year to set an example for others. I was pushed by Mr. Swain, my senior year, to take the leadership positions I had on campus more seriously. Finally, and eventually, I learned that the phrase, enter to learn and leave to serve, is actually just another way of saying, enter to learn and leave to lead. Academically, I know we painted a somewhat dramatic picture earlier on, but the truth of the matter is this. Justin-Siena is a place where they recognize the difference between academic excellence and racking up fives on AP tests. As proof, I have only my own experience, but I hope that counts for something. You've heard a little about how Justin-Siena has shaped me. Well, I would like to offer the results. My past year at Princeton, I took what is often considered the hardest course available to freshmen, and I got an A. I also served as a writing tutor for my peers and was elected vice president of student-run philosophical society. This past summer, I actually spent mostly in Istanbul and various parts of Greece, studying the effects of the Treaty of Lausanne on modern-day issues. Through all of these things, Justin-Siena prepared me well, not only in academics, but also by giving me the skills and the values, as well as the confidence, to succeed in all of these various ventures. Right, now here's the catch. So, I was asked to speak today because this school, along with everything I've just said, is ultimately a result of your support. This includes your time, your parents, but also your financial support. Now, I'm not really in much of a position to speak about financial independence or about what to do with money, seeing as I don't really have any. But I can say that at school, whenever topic of our high schools comes up, I always hear comments about